Hey guys, welcome to the Playing with Power box opening stream, which the first of two. We're doing another one tomorrow night, and that'll be Ryan and Zach when they open their boxes. If you're wondering what this is for, there is a Commander, I don't know exactly what you call it, like box opening league that SCG put out, and Sheldon was a part of that, and it's pretty much here's the basis of what it is. You buy a booster box, standard legal, or I don't think it has to be current standard legal, but standard legal at one point. You open it and you build a commander deck out of it, and you play it against other people who do it, pretty much the same thing. And then you get more packs like this, and each week you add six more packs, and then it's kind of like a league like that. So that's what we'll be doing tonight. We are doing the box opening and brewing of the original decks. So I chose Core Set 2020 because I'm trying to live the Golos dream of playing five color good stuff. So yeah, looking forward to opening this box. Yeah, I'm joined tonight by Mike.
Hey everyone, I've got an Ikoria box and looking forward to opening that. So yeah, should be a good time. Let's go ahead and get started.
I'm gonna dive on into it. So. Okay. It is.
Can you all hear Folger talking? Everybody hear Folger?
Oh, can they not?
Just to make sure. Okay.
Is that a yes?
Seems to be a yes. Yep. We got some yeses.
Okay.
Okay. We are not banning Dominaria. We are letting Ryan play Dominaria because
I was like, we're letting it happen. I actually do have a question. Does this follow the commander ban list?
Because it does.
With Ikoria, you can open Lutri.
And Lutri is hard banned, so no Lutri.
Yeah. Figured.
Yeah, pretty unfortunate.
Yeah. I was thinking about that when I was like skimming through different the set lists and stuff. So, as far as sorting, because we're going to brew decks off of this, I'm probably going to go legendaries up top, and then I'll probably sort by rarity, and then I can break it down into color and all that stuff when we're brewing later. So, without further ado, let's open us a Golos. I'm going to need your guys' support. So.
Pack one, pick one Golos, easy.
I'll pack one it? Alright. Is this good enough that they can, like, see it? Maybe not read the card, but like...
Not read the card, but they are, yeah.
Okay.
Looks good. Bone to Ash is playable.
Bone to Ash. This is...
Paradise is playable.
That's ramp. Mana Fixing. Pacifism's playable.
Everyone loves Pacifism.
Let's see. All right. So there's that. Now we're into the uncommons. Diviner's Lockbox. Choose a card here. Huh. I will take that's a good one too.
Yep.
Actually, this is like the super OP one for this, just because it like one hits.
Yeah. You know.
Okay, cool. So here's my Kaikar Spirit that I'm gonna open. Here's a dual land which I'm gonna need. Commons go here. Got the Scryland is the rare, and Loxodon Life Chanter. So that should be good.
Yep. You should definitely read some of the cards. If you think that a card's very good, you should definitely read it off.
Yeah, for sure. So far we've got a temple, which is very good for our fixing, because obviously I'm gonna open a Golos somewhere. We're gonna need to play five colors. And then Loxodon Life Chanter is just a really, really good thick boy. But I'll just read the card because it's like super uncommon. Exactly. So it's five and a white for a elephant cleric 4/6. It has, when Loxodon Life Chanter enters the battlefield, you may have your life total become the total toughness of creatures you control. And then it has an activated ability of 5 and a white, Loxodon Life Chanter gets +X/+X until end of turn, where X is your life total. So, like, I mean, just give this evasion of some kind, and you're paying 6 mana to kill a player. which that's pretty good. So, pack numero dos. What are some of the like big hits here? We're talking Veil of Summerfoil, yeah. Golos.
Field of the Dead is like $18 now.
I was going to say, Field of the Dead is actually, if I'm living the true Golos dream, I'm opening both Golos and Field of the Dead, and then that's just like the deck I'm playing.
Yeah.
But, all right, Convolute, decent counterspell. I'm noticing that I have a lot of like red goblin stuff going on in here.
Yeah. I mean, I think counterspells are still going to be good.
I actually don't know. Target player discards two cards. It's kind of mean. Enters the battlefield, draw a card. Playable, dude.
Yeah, Flying Elvish Visionary.
Yeah.
Brandborn is pretty sweet. Get through it.
Yeah. Cryptic. Ooh.
Fetchable with Golos.
I was going to say. Chandra's Spitfire. Tail's End. That's actually playable,
that's
probably.
That's great, yeah. Some good blue cards so far, for sure.
Yeah,
Chandra
no doubt.
Chandra Yarok.
No, there's not. I don't think there's enough ETB stuff for Yarok to be good
you
with just
the
M20. That's true. These
decks will not be very competitive. If I'm being totally honest, I think the gameplay will be entertaining because they will be long Battlecruiser games, so that'll be fun. There will be a video version of this. And we did talk about doing like Modern Masters and like. Yeah, Eternal
all
Masters.
All the crazy stuff. Yeah.
I mean, we are called Playing with Power, so you think we would kind of bump it up a notch, but man, those boxes are expensive.
I was going to say, like, it
would have been
not,
like $1,000 for us to play that.
I was going to say, well, like, it's, I'm pretty sure, like, the original Modern Masters is, like, over $500 a piece now, which is just ridiculous. Man, I've got a lot of these tokens, like, the Raise the Alarm. I could definitely see a Kai card deck.
Yeah. But you get, keep in mind, though, you can only play one copy of each card.
Yeah.
Small Splicer is a good...
Golem Tribal, dude.
Tomebound Lich is sweet. It's a Death Toucher, lifelink 1-3. When it enters or deals combat damage.
Deals? Yeah. That is good. Choose target permanent card in your graveyard that was put there. There's an effect on your hand. All right, cool. Legion's End.
It's removal.
And a foil, which is Sorcerer of the Fang. So Legion's End is definitely removal. I don't know if it's good. I have a feeling we're going to end up in like pretty Battlecruiser-y type of games.
Yeah.
I don't know how good Legion's End will actually be.
Yeah, that's fair, actually. It's good in like, or it was good in Standard.
Yeah, no, it's really good in Standard, but like I don't know how many creatures will be 2 CMC or less.
Yep.
So that's a hard maybe on that one.
So Ice Phoenix asks, do we all watch Play to Win often? What's our opinion of their channel and their level of being competitive? I do watch them, and I like them. And they've actually been on our channel before. They're really, really cool guys. And so I would say they do. I mean, they play CDH. They play, you know, the same stuff that we do.
Yeah. They play CDH. I mean, obviously, like, I think every CDH channel kind of dabbles in some fringe tier decks, but like, I mean, that they're still part of CDH, so I think their power level is good. And from what I've seen, they're like really great guys and they make good content, so definitely check them out. More CDH players, the better.
Yep.
Okay, Inspired Charge.
It's a pump. There's your Yarok.
Dude,
right
there's
there.
My Yarok. There's my Octoprophet.
My ETB Scry too.
Let's see.
So he picked Core 20 over Core 2021 for one very specific reason, and that
it's
is...
Golos.
it's Golos. We're riding the Golos train.
Murder is actually good.
Yeah, Murder's good.
Chandra's Embercat.
Kind of rampy sometimes.
Kind of. Elemental or Chandra Planeswalker. Fry?
Fry is definitely playable.
I would probably say so. Loyal Pegasus, probably not. Oh, yes! We're hitting it.
Fixing.
This card's just, fixing in ramp. Wake Root Elemental. It's a sticky boy. And another foil.
We're just foiling out the draft deck. Like three foils already.
Yeah. So Scuttlebutt is like the main hit here, for sure. This is like one of the cards I definitely needed to open. Mana Fixing is going to be super important for this. And it is... everything I want in a Golos deck. And then Wake Root Elemental is also good, just because it's really It's a thicky boy. I don't know if he'll ever activate its ability, but like a 5-5 is... I don't know if you can tell based off what I'm talking about here. The power level may not be great, but this 5-5 could win a game.
Yeah, so the rules of this format are you open a box, and you just have to pick one of the legendaries that you open. And then you have to build your deck out of the box, one of each card, and the same commander ban list. After the first week, you add 6 packs of a different set, and then you repeat that 2 more times, so a total of 1 month of playing. If anyone is interested in playing the format, we do have a TCG affiliate link at the bottom. If you'd like to purchase a booster box for your, you know, for yourself, get your play group to play. It seems really fun so far. Plus, you know, you get to rip packs and actually do something with them.
Which is like, That's any like, justification to rip packs and actually have a use? Like, that. There it is, man.
Exactly.
That's all we could ever want. All right, so Anticipate is a very good card. That's a definite playable. Against First Strike. Oh, how fun. Interesting. This card is actually super good. Audacious Thief.
Yeah, so that's great.
It's 2 and a black for a 2/2. Whenever Audacious Thief attacks, you draw a card and lose a life. So that's a very good playable. Here's another one. Leafkin Druid, which is 1 and a green for a 0/3 that has tapped at a green. If you control 4 or more creatures, add 2 green instead.
More ETB. Look at this. The Yorok deck's all coming together.
Dude, I even got the Leafkin Druid for it, dude. Watch out.
Risen Reef is coming.
You think so? Empyrean Eagle. That's a Kaikar card
that's,
for
sure. I was about to say, that's a Kaikar
card. That's a Kaikar card. And there's Battlefield. Yorok, dude. To make a 2/2 token.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Barkhide Troll is decent for beating face.
Hey, there's
another
a Scryland.
Look at this fixing.
Look at this fixing we got going on here, man.
Yep. So yeah.
I can just
one of the other rules is you open what you play with whatever lands that you open along with basic lands that you
basics. Have. Yeah.
That's play.
Card doesn't. Yeah, definitely. 2-mana 3/3 defender. It's not Act of Treason's probably playable. Death Touch draw card, maybe.
Make a 2/2.
ETB, dude. It's Yorok.
Yeah. It's all together. Rabbit
that's a
Bite's
good one.
Great.
Yeah.
Blight Beetle's rude. AF.
Hey, this
that
is a good card.
Sweet. Rapacious Dragon, make 2 treasures.
Yeah. Deals 2 damage to any target.
That's good, too.
Steel Overseer, huh? I don't... is there anything I can do with a Steel Overseer? I don't actually...
Not
Oh, no. He pumps my Golos that I'm going to open.
Oh,
that's
there
right.
You go.
There it is, dude. So, not looking too bad so far. Definitely lots of playables, which is, I think, the second most important thing. Now, obviously, we are hunting for some legendaries, so...
Yep. So, after we... after me and Folger both... open our boxes, we're going to be brewing our decks. I think I have a feeling it's going to be pretty straightforward, but I know Ikoria has a ton of legendaries, so that should be fun.
Ton, dude. ETB, make 2/2s.
Oh,
the value.
That card? I used to play that in my sideboard with Vivian in Historic.
Sephara. And
nice.
Another rare.
There's, hey, there's your first legendary creature.
That, hey, you're not wrong. I will do everything in my power not to play it, but you're right. That is my first legendary creature.
Matt,
to be fair, Sephara is very good if I open Kaikar.
That's true.
Like a 1-mana 7/7 flying lifelink that gives my other flyers indestructible with like Kaikar is like super strong.
Yeah.
So that's a good hit if I can obviously hit a better legendary than Sephara. But at the very least, I can make a deck. Not a good one, but a deck. I've hit
if
a legendary.
If you have 100 cards, you're playing 40 planes, that's for sure.
Yeah. No kidding.
Yeah, Woodland Champion is awesome, too. I think you got one of those in there somewhere.
Yeah. This, honestly, you're right about the Yorok, where I've hit a bunch of ETB stuff so far.
Yeah. It's actually crazy.
Here's another Kaikar card. 2 and a blue, draw 2, but then it gets reduced if you control a flyer.
Yep.
Eternal, put target creature on the card. This card's solid playable removal for sure.
Yep.
Eternal Isolation, one and a white, put target creature with power 4 or greater on the bottom of its owner's library. Thrashing Brontodon, another playable.
That's a beautiful card.
Masking
Demolition would be pretty cool with Kaikar, I think.
I think it would as well. Marauding Raptor. What, I've never seen this good. One and a red for a 2/3. Creature spells you cast cost one less to cast. Whenever another creature enters the battlefield under your control, Marauding Raptor deals 2 damage to it. If a dinosaur is dealt damage this way, Marauding Raptor gets +2/+7 until end of turn. Very interesting. And the foil Yara. The foil Yara Wave Crasher.
4 foils? 5 foils already? That's crazy.
I have 5 foils so far.
That's insane. You opened what? That 6 is, packs?
Something like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7.
7 packs, 5 foils.
The foil god. Yarox Wave Crasher, dude.
This guy's like got a full extra booster pack over here.
You're not wrong.
Yeah, Dominaria is going to be insane, especially if he gets Tadiova. I'm really hoping he doesn't play Tadiova because it's too easy.
Well, I'm more afraid of Moldrotha and then Tadiova in the 99, to be fair.
That's true.
Flame Sweep is playable.
That
especially
is playable.
That's a Kaikar card as well.
Yep.
This is another good card, actually. So it's a Angel of Vitality, 2 and a white for a flying 2/2. And it has, if you would gain life, you gain that much life, +1 instead. But the main thing is Angel of Vitality has +2/+2 as long as you have 25 life or more. So in Commander, it's a 3 mana 4/4 flyer. Bloodsoaked Altar. Yeah. Oh, it's an artifact. Oh, 3 CMC. All right. Icon of Ancestry, creatures of a chosen type, another Kaikar card for spirits.
Ooh, yeah.
Definitely decent. So far, so good. I'm definitely hitting playables, which is definitely the most important thing.
So, Eldraine, I got some extra packs of Eldraine because I thought it looked really fun. The issue is there's not a ton of legendary creatures in the set. And we can't speak of the Fat Tadiova partner yet because technically it has not been released yet or revealed.
What
I don't
is
think.
It?
The not yet spoiled, or sorry, the spoiled not yet revealed card.
Oh, okay. I know what you're talking about. Yeah. Also, look at this board wipe we got here. Kind of.
What's that
Captivating. Captivating Gyre, 4 blue-blue for a sorcery, return up to 3 target creatures to their owner's hands. Might of the Masses.
It's
not bad.
Spell. You can get some
dude,
money.
Rule of Law. Let's get them.
Golos. Actually,
that's there's another legendary.
Nice. You better read us that one because that card's awesome.
I was like, this card is both awesome and is a huge bomb for this. So it's 3 green, Gargros, and Vicious Watcher. It's a Hydra. It has Vigilance. Hydra spells you cast cost 4 less to cast. Whenever a creature you control becomes the target of a spell, Gargos Vicious Watcher fights up to 1 target creature you don't control.
And that it's is a 6/7 for 6.
It's an 8. It's an 8/7
eight,
for
7.
Eight,
oh my god.
8/7 Vig for 6. That is definitely a powerful card.
Yeah, I was thinking Eldraine would be really good as a support set.
Yeah.
I gotta get me an Oko in my deck.
I was gonna say if you can hit the Oko Dream. Ooh, here's some elemental boy. Portal, return target control.
That's a Yarnrock card. Read that one. That card's insane.
That, oh, dude, the value in Yarnrock. Pro Black. There's another Yarnrock card. Look at this other foil, by the way. It's a spicy foil,
happening?
Too. Colossus Hammer.
Our goal here. Yeah, why don't you read Dread Presence off? That card's awesome.
This card is very good if I can get it rolling in a Yarok deck. So it's 3 and a black for a 3/3 Nightmare. Whenever a swamp enters the battlefield under your control, choose 1. Yeah, I can either you draw a card and lose a life, or Dread Presence deals 2 damage to any target and you gain 2 life. The any target there is very relevant. And in a Yarok, it double triggers. So it's incredibly good in Yarok. All right. So I am about to open my, what would this be? 8th pack? No. How many?
Yarnrock
is
bust.
It per book?
36 packs.
It's 36, so yeah. Then I'm opening my 12th pack right now. Definitely not bad so far, but I definitely have not hit the legendaries that I need.
We haven't got the Veil of Summer or the Golos.
We have not got the Veil. Yes, which is obviously what we're looking for.
Go back to that silver gorilla, dude. That thing's sweet.
Silver gorilla.
The drowsy card with the
Silverback
AoEs.
shaman. Dude, Yarok or Busk is right, apparently.
Yep.
Scholar
Ooh,
of
that's a good
Ages.
one too.
Return up to two target instant sorcery cards from graveyard to your hand.
When it ETBs.
There's another flame sweep. Leyline of Sanctity. I
I
don't.
don't even
I
think
gotta
we're
check.
playing that.
What do you mean? Is it playable? I'd say you're probably right. There's definitely ley lines that I do think are playable. The green and blue one, I think we play.
Oh yeah,
I don't
definitely. Blue.
know about the red or black.
I would actually. I think blue would be playable. I don't even think the green one, unless you have a ton of mana dorks, but you would need a lot.
I was gonna say, I think the only one in the set is like Leafkin Druid, so that would be
Yeah.
impressive. The Audacious Thief, man. Love that card, actually. Yep, there's that Leafkin Druid. God's willing. This is the Pro and Scry. Ooh,
There's your reanimate spell.
there's a reanimate spell. Barkhide. Oh,
A
hey, there's a.
planeswalker.
And it's a mythic. Let's go, dude. So, Mu Yeelin Sky Dancer. So, love this card. It's one blue for a legendary planeswalker, Yeelin. And it comes in with two loyalty. It has plus two until your next turn. Up to one target creature gets -2/-0, and loses flying. -3, make a 4/4 blue elemental bird creature token with flying. And then obviously the ultimate is you get an emblem with islands you control have tap draw a card. That's a definite. That's I don't see a world I'm not playing that unless I'm not playing blue.
Yeah.
Like planeswalkers are just in draft style formats are incredibly strong. Okay. I could play mill. It's another Yara card.
We haven't even seen one Golos card yet, except for maybe that one, Rapacious
I was
Dragon.
gonna say, technically every
Yeah, I
card.
guess.
Okay,
Spectral
so
Sailor is
yes,
awesome.
that's actually. Oh, it's a legendary. All right, boys.
Ooh, this looks like a multicolor one too.
It's a multicolor
It's gotta
legendary.
be Yarok. Oh!
The
We
dream!
got it!
The dream!
Oh
We
my
did
god, we're doing Yarok.
Yarok
that a foil?
or Bust. That's
Another
another
foil.
foil fairy miscreant, dude. The Yarok
He's
doom
about to get the
was
most busted Yarok deck I've ever seen.
We just keep opening ETB Yarok stuff. Can't complain
Unbelievable.
there. Oh, well, I can rest easy
Okay.
now. I hit
Yeah.
I hit a good commander at least. So
That's so
now
funny.
it's just
We've been building this Yarok deck the whole time too.
I know. Oh, this isn't bad. One mana kill a creature to send. She has sack one. It's not hateful.
Now, if you open a Golos, that's just unfair.
I was gonna say, if I open Golos and get to play like Yarok in the 99, like
Yeah.
we're doing it, dude. Oh, Hail
Hail
Summer.
Summer, let's go. We definitely
There
played
we
the Tollbound
go.
Lich.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what
Yeah.
deck you're in.
I was gonna say, if I'm playing Yarok or not. Ooh, that's another Scry land.
Yeah, but
But I
you
like
have that
to
one
see.
already. Oof.
No, I don't.
You don't have Temple of Mystery?
All right, so Scry lands
I
we
thought the first
have.
card you opened was.
No, I have
Oh my
Temple of
god, you have three
Epiphany.
Skrylands.
I got three Skylands so far. That's awesome. Yeah. Got the Veil of Summer too. That's what I'm talking
Just
about.
imagine getting to play all of those legendaries up there in your Golos deck.
I know, right?
That sounds messed up.
This is why the Golos dream is where it's at, because you get to play it all.
Yep.
Dude, the Octoprophet, Scry
Dude's gonna be
4.
amazing.
Too much value. This battlefield created 2/2 creature token for each card named Undead Servant in your graveyard. I can never
Not
trade it,
playable.
unfortunate.
Yeah.
Unfortunate.
That card's
Yeah.
sweet. Unlimited.
3/3. Oh, it's Star 5? No kidding. Diamond Knight. Choose a color. That card's not bad. Whenever you lose life for the first time each turn, put a 1/1 counter.
Decent.
It's not bad. Starfield Mystic.
That's an
Don't think
enchantress card.
it is. I don't think that one's particularly playable.
I don't think so.
I don't think there's enough
Oh.
enchantments. What's up?
Imagine a world where you play Yarok and then you play your Golos and you get double landfall triggers.
Dude!
That
Come on. And then Field of the Dead? Come on, dude. This is that's the Golos into Field of the Dead with Yorok's energies is like the deck I'd please give me Golos. Or even just Field of the Dead with Yorok is good enough, man. Like, come on.
That's true, that's true.
Got another of that Iron Root Warlord.
Ooh, oh my reef. God, there it is. There it is. Reef. We got there.
That's nice. What is this card?
Ooh, I saw that last card too. That's an amazing card for this.
Lotus Field.
Actually, that's a bad card for Yarok.
I was that is not a Yarok card. That is
no, still a good
maybe
card.
Maybe a Golos card? I don't know. Of any one color, maybe not. But maybe, who knows? It's kind of fixing, but kind of not really.
Yeah.
I'm playing Risen. Oh god, I got the Risen Reef.
I know. You're literally just missing Field of Dead and Golos now. You've still got like so many packs left.
Yeah, I've got about a half of them left.
There's another Elemental card.
Overgrowth Elemental. Isn't this actually one of the good ones?
Yeah,
it is. Gauntlets of Light. I got another foil. Night.
That card's awesome.
This card is awesome.
Another foil. One.
So, Nightpack Ambusher. 2 green green for a 4/4 with flash. Other wolves and werewolves you control get +1/+1. At the beginning of your end step, if you didn't cast a spell this turn, create a 2/2 green wolf creature token, which is really a 3/3 with it. So that's a very good card. Another foil. Battalion Foot Soldier, which is the searches up a lot of battalion foot soldiers or whatever.
Stone
not very good.
Stone Cold Unplayable.
Yes. For sure. Okay. Dude, game 6 with the Lord of the Valley.
It's an elemental, technically. So
it
it's
is
something.
Flying Haste 2/2. Devout Decree. Exile target creature or planeswalker. That's black or red scry one. Oh play. My god.
You know,
I just saw
it
in the corner.
That? Oh no. Oh no.
I think I might have gotten it. Please.
No! Oh, no way!
There it is! Yes, dude.
I can't believe
the Golos dream is alive. All right.
This is unbelievable.
Field of the Dead, boys.
How
say
do I
it
beat
with
this?
Me.
How do I beat this?
Field of the Dead. Oh, yes. There he is, dude. All right, we just need Field of the Dead, and my deck is done, dude. That's what I'm talking about. All right.
Man. It's going to happen. You know it's going to happen.
It's going to hit his destiny, dude. I called the Golos.
There's no justice in the world.
Enchant creature. I think I just opened another foil. Oh, this card's actually really good.
That card's sweet. Yeah, it's going to be good.
Dungeon guys, gross. I opened a foil. What is this? Oh, it's like the Chandra. Oh, wait. Isn't there a really good Chandra in this set?
Yeah, one of them. I think the mythic one.
Dragonseth
is still good. Evolving Wilds, there you go.
Super good. Evolving Wilds for fixing. Dungeon Geist. That's the ETB one, right?
Why do you read Dragonseth? That card is so busted.
It is. Also, look at my Golos big boy pile, by the way. So I got a foil Dracuseth. 4 red for a 7/7 flyer. That's right, it's super Inferno Titan. When Dracuseth, Maw of Flames attacks, it deals 4 damage to any target and 3 damage to each of up to 2 other targets. So definitely.
You got some reanimation stuff too. And some discard, actually.
I know. I might be able to play like 5 color good stuff with like Reanimator. That'd be sick. All right. If we hit a Field of the Dead at this point, man, like
you stop opening packs. You're like, this is the deck. We did it.
Yeah, pretty much. From graveyard to hand, not bad. Other elemental synergy.
Yeah, now you get to play all the Scrylands. That's a good point, Eric.
Yeah, I get to play all of them, and if I have Yorok, the double trigger, like the value. All right. Unplayable. Loaming Shaman is actually not that bad.
Yeah.
Adds when only a cast.
That card's amazing with Golos. Read that.
This
card
is so good. Card. Yeah, it's a 2-mana 1/3 that taps for 2.
Turn three Golos. I knew it was gonna happen.
Oh, another Scry land, and it's one of the ones I don't have. I have 4 now. Look at this mana fixing, boys. Look at it.
Show off the all your common dual lands too, and your evolving wilds.
Yeah. See, that's a good question. Let's do some skimming real quick. So we have the evolving wilds.
Yep. You got some of the duels too. I'm sure you get all of them by the end.
That's what I'm checking for
right now. I think you're there. There's five, right? Oh, there's 10.
I guess.
Looks like there's 10. Well, we're 6 out of 10 so far, so.
I have 6 out of 10. So we got red, red, white, red, green. We're missing red, blue.
Yeah, you're going to open Omnath and just bring it all together.
Just get it all.
You can still land like turn 3 Risen Reef and then turn 4
Turn
Golos.
3 They're not even wrong.
Or turn 4 Yarok and get double triggers off of Yarok and Risen Reef.
Yeah. Oh, I'm just so happy I opened Golos, man. Saves it. I mean, to be fair, the Golos or the Yarok deck we had was going to be
It was going to be really good.
Disfigure. Target creature gets -2/-2 until end of turn. Instant. It's not painful.
I'd play it.
Yeah, yes. Yarok spent like your game.
Fit the theme.
Chandra's Regulator.
Unplayable.
Oh, I got a foil forest.
Hey.
Whenever I feel a little bit. Yeah, definitely unplayable. Unless I. What are some other. I really would like to get the 6 mana mythic Chandra. It's like it has the uptick loyalty that gives the emblem to all players.
Oh, that would be so busted.
Yeah.
And it's a wrath too. You can deal through all 3
yes.
damage to each non-elemental creature.
Correct. Unsummoned, that's playable
yeah.
for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, I'd probably play it.
Fencing Ace. This spell can't be countered. Target
that's
opponent
so
reveals their hand. Exile all the oh it is. Hey, dude.
So much Reclaimer, dude.
If we can hit a Field of the Dead, this deck is so good.
We got a tutor for Field of the Dead. Elvish Reclaimer can tap 2, sack a land, and search for a land and put it in play tapped.
Yeah, it lets me hit my Scrylands with Yarok. I already have a Dismal Backwater, right? Yeah, I do. Okay. Alright, we're about 2/3 of the way through this box opening.
This deck's probably better than a Precon.
The only thing that this deck will be missing out on is ramp, which is kind
yeah.
of a, like, I think that's one of the things that'll hold us back. Negate, though, is playable.
Oh, yeah, we're slamming Negate.
Yeah. Duress is probably playable. I think I already got my Cryptic Caves.
You did get a Cryptic Caves, which is good.
Oh, dude, I got Bad Overrun, which is still Overrun.
Yeah.
Hey! The board wrath we needed! There's the wrath, man. Let's go. And it's a really good one too, because it lets me put one back.
Yeah, Flood of Tears lets you return all non-token permanents.
Return all non-land permanents to their owner's hands. If you return 4 or more non-token permanents you control this way, you may put a permanent card from your hand onto the battlefield.
It's a really good card. That's a good commander card in general.
Oh no, I have a Kugolos deck, like. An actual Golos deck.
Yeah.
And it's mono blue, and it uses Flood of Tears as a ritual sometimes, where it's able to, yeah, it's really weird, but sometimes you're able to just bounce your entire board, tap a Nykthos, replay it all, and it just rituals. And so it's a super sweet card.
There is a tutor in this deck, and it's called Scheming Symmetry. And
I was going to say.
Going to open it so you can activate his Golos and cast whatever spell.
You know, Scheming Symmetry and the Golos put Dracuseth into play and just get there, dude. Mystic Forge. Is there a way I can make this work? I really doubt it. I opened another foil, though. Not a playable one.
That's crazy. That's so many foils.
This is actually another. I think I've hit. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so I'm at 7 of the gain lifelands. So we got the fixin' for the Golos going on. All right. Pray with me, dude. What are the two? Is there any, like, cards? There's Field of the Dead. Is there any other cards we're like, desperately looking for?
Foil Veil of Summer for the value.
That is true. Veil of Summer for the value. Open another foil. Yeah. Gift of Paradise, that's for sure playable.
Yeah, definitely.
Lightning Stormkin.
Noxious Grasp is very playable. That's amazing.
So this card is super playable, and I opened. I believe it's Kaikar.
Oh no! Oh no! Yeah, buddy. He getting all the mythics. Yeah. Look at these mythics.
There's a foil Plummet.
It's shared summons in this set. Oh my god.
It is.
That would do it. I'd search up Yarok and Kaikar. Good luck, everybody else.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, I have basically everything I've wanted now except for Field of the Dead. Yep. So, and it's a rare, so I've got a chance here in these last like 10 packs.
Ooh, Agent of Treachery. I think Garrett's.
Oh my god. That's true. You gotta hit Agent of Treachery. Dude, this Howling Giant is gonna be valuable.
That card's gonna be amazing, yeah.
Knight of the Even and not terrible.
That's a good standard and historic or pioneer card.
I think I already have this Scarred Barons.
Yeah, I see somebody in chat talking about Epic Loot Springfield. Kevin Collinsworth.
Pretty sure that guy. Pretty sure I know that guy as well. It's Casual Kevin.
Casual
as
Kevin.
As we call him. Alright, boys. Let's hit this Field of the Dead. An Agent of Treachery, and we can go home. We'll be done.
Gravediggers would be good.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh, you did not just get that Mythic Chandra. Oh my god! He's getting Field
of the Dead.
You're getting Field of the Dead. Is it a guarantee at this point?
Is it a guarantee? Oh, it's the craziest one I've ever seen. That's fourth Mythic? That's like average, or... Right? Isn't it average four mythics or something like that?
I think it's. Is it four? I thought it was six, maybe. I'm not really sure.
Neither do I, but I've hit four really, really, really good ones. So.
If you, like, sent me a picture of all of these cards that you opened and I hadn't been watching you open them, I would call you a liar.
That's probably fair. I mean, I've hit it all but Field of the Dead at this point.
Yeah, we're not really looking for too much else. The God Box.
Like Agent of Treachery, maybe?
Oh, yeah.
Here it is.
What do you know?
What do you know? It's an Agent of Treachery, boys.
Okay,
bada
so
bin, bada boom.
Your next pack's going to be Field of the Dead.
So we got seven packs left to open Field of the Dead.
My box is going to be even better. You just wait.
I'm rooting for you, Mike. I hope we get, like, crazy decks for this. Oh, the Agent of Treachery.
This is rigged. I know it feels rigged, doesn't it? I don't want to play against this. I wouldn't agree with this rig.
Air Elemental.
Hey.
Another Dracuseth. Fortunately, cannot play. I unfortunately cannot play two.
We got six more shots.
Six more shots at the Field of the Dead dream.
M20 is really good. This is, like... Honestly, this is way better than I expected.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, it is the Field of the Dead dream, because look at all these, like, multiple non-basics I have.
Oh, I know, you barely need to run basics.
Yeah, I'm gonna run, like, 20 basics and be fine if I hit Field of the Dead.
Hi, Grant. I am doing Ikoria, because I like big stompy boys. And I want to play some Kogla. I at least want to put them in my deck. Ringleader,
dude,
a Planeswalker. No,
it's the third walker, and it's also playable, dude. Get in here. Another mythic. So that's five mythics.
I think the magical Christmas land scenario for my box is Gigantha and, like, a bunch of ultimatums and stuff like that. There's, like, a lot of really
almost
good...
surely, yeah. The ultimate, I picked Ikoria as one of my other sets for the Golo stream to try and hit specifically ultimatums. Because all like if you ever just cast an ultimatum in the format that this is, like you just like kind of win, I think.
Yeah.
Farai, Loyal Pegasus, Aether Guest.
That's a great card too.
It is. Hey,
that's a great card too.
That is, and I think this is one of the last ones of those that I need.
Yep, Drawn from Dreams is 4 mana. Dig Through Time.
Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what colors am I missing here?
Oh, you know what I just thought about? I think there's
red,
a box hopper in the Sikoria box.
Is there?
There, I don't know. They opened one the other day, and there was one in it.
Oh, that's right. No, yeah, you'll have the you get a you got the free shoot, what's it called? It's the Godzilla cards or whatever it is.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep, the Godzilla cards. I'll save that one for last.
Yeah, that's our way we end the opening. All right, baby. Feel the dead. I can feel it. Make it happen. Oh, I hit another Chandra.
Yeah, Chandra's good.
Nope. Regine, rotting Regisaur.
That's risky.
Yeah, it's probably too risky. I did hit another Chandra, though, so that's awesome.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, even uncommon Chandra is super good.
If it leaves the turn, it can just ramp.
Yeah.
Yeah, we will be posting our deck lists online. And
yes.
If you didn't see it down at the bottom, Zach and Ryan are going to be opening theirs tomorrow, too. And it's going to be us four playing against each other.
I think I just hit the last temple I needed. I think that's I'm not kidding. I think that's all five. One, two, three, four, five.
That's crazy.
All five temples. No duplicate temples either. All right.
Two
Unfortunately, for the Feel of the Dead dream, I'm going to weep. This deck is everything I want if I hit field. Even if I don't hit field, I think the deck is more than reasonable.
Yeah, if you do hit field, we're playing our CDH decks against you.
Not that good, but yeah, I appreciate that.
Sweet.
That is sweet. I hit another something.
Yeah. Oh my god, put it on top with your scheming symmetry,
dude,
that you're about to open.
So I only have one pack left, unfortunately. Although I have a really good five color just big boy deck. Like Meteor Golem, Vilas, Sephara, Gargos, Dracoseth, Golos is the commander.
Yeah.
All right, boys. It is the final pack. We're going to hit, hopefully, Field of the Dead. It's the only thing that I haven't opened that I like that one. Or Scheming Symmetry. Either or would be great hits. All right, so let's see. All right, there's the commons. Here's the uncommons.
That card's amazing.
I hit Leyline.
That's a good one. It's not a Field of the Dead, but Leyline.
It's not a Field of the Dead.
It's a great card.
And I think I actually hit 9 out of 10 of the... Yeah,
that's a
I hit
lot
9.
Of lands.
So I hit 9 out of the 10 duels in Evolving Wilds in all 5 temples. So I think my fixing for my Golos is going to be, super strong.
Yeah, that's crazy. We'll take Leyline Anticipation. I mean, that's still going to be a great card.
Yeah, I don't see there's any way I'm not playing that. Like, just because, the 100 cards is going to be rough.
Yep.
So that's my box opening, boys. I'm going to organize this, put some of the highlights together, and then we can discuss, so to speak.
Are we doing your deck building first and then the box reveal?
No, I say we open yours next. I'm just going to... Do some quick organizing here.
You do your thing. I'm going to step away for 1 sec, and then I'm going to swap it over, and we'll go ahead and start opening mine.
Sounds good. So, yeah, that happened. This deck is going to be sweet. Got all the big boys we could ever want. We hit all 3 planeswalkers we wanted. We hit what I would argue would be the 3 best legendaries. I guess. Hold on. What's the blue one? Because I know this was a cycle. I can't think of the blue one. This Chandra is a hard maybe on the playable. That's probably going to be close. Both of these foils are super playable. It's another big boy. Veil of Summer might not be. However, the Golos will be our commander for sure. And the fixing we got for the Golos is ideal. And I may have not have hit Field of the Dead, which is unfortunate. However, the ability to just Golos to grab any 2 colors I need is going to be super strong, especially with the Scrylands. And if I flood, I can play the one that has draw card on it, which is somewhere in this pile. But okay. Yeah, this deck looks super strong. Golos will be the commander, and I'm going to be playing five color good stuff with emphasis on really good stuff that's just really big. I will probably also put a Kaikar package and a Yarok package in.
Oh, it definitely would be. You have some insane cards for Yarok.
Yeah, for sure. And then Kaikar just kind of naturally ramps me as well. And I'll probably, like, that lets me use payoffs with the stack. Yeah. So cards like Drawn from Dreams is great. Agent
That's going to be so messed up.
Flood it, like, yeah.
Yeah, you've got a couple different ways to kind of wrath the board. You've got interaction, you've got some big things to ramp into. You have a little bit of ramp, not a ton. But
yeah, I think the ramp is going to be the one problem, is going to be ramp. So I think I just have to play a bunch of lands to try to hit my... Because I think this deck tries to ramp to 7, realistically.
Oh, definitely. Like, that Renowned Weaponsmith is going to be insane.
Oh, yeah, turn 3 Golos? Like, yeah. Come on! Yeah. I think this deck is awesome. I opened every single card I wanted except for Field of the Dead.
Yep. You got a Lotus Field. You can search it up. Put some lands in Graveyard.
Yeah. Do some stuff.
All right. I'm going to swap it over. Yeah, that was
awesome. Swap it over.
And after I open my box, for those of you that are just joining, we will be doing deck building and stuff like that. So if you want to check out how insane his deck is, we'll also be posting them probably on Twitter, I'm guessing, after we actually get our decks together. Okay, let's see it. How's that look? Ooh, that is not great. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we've got this Ikoria box here. Let's go ahead and get started. Is everything looking okay on my screen right now? Everybody able to see stuff?
That's what I'm checking out. I would move it to the left a bit more. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that looks good, Mike.
Okay, cool. All right, so I think I have a box topper. We're going to see. Just ripped the plastic. Oof.
Oh, double.
Look at that, Ikoria box topper. Awesome.
Yeah, buddy.
Just set that to the side.
Okay. This deck is so insane. This deck is ridiculous.
I'm going to get a Vivian.
Yeah, the Vivian's a really good hit.
Yeah.
Do I actually need that?
If you all couldn't tell, I really love green cards. Me and Folger both do. But there's a lot of really sweet green cards in this set that I'm trying to open. Okay, so put these over here. Yeah, I love this playmat. Alright, so... Oh, these are, I think... Yep, these ones are backwards. Okay, so for Ikoria, the rare is in the front, so we're going to work backwards.
I was going to say, you're going to just flip it upside. Yep. Or, what is it? Take the top 5, put it at the back, and I think that fixes it.
So I think I'm going to put it... Yeah, I think I'm going to put the cards I think that are, like, playable or, like, pretty good separate. And then just kind of have a pile of random stuff. So we've got... There's a lot of... Ikoria has a lot of random, like, 1-mana cyclers. I think those are all going to be good. Just... Because 1-mana cycling is, like, free, basically. So we've got some... Let's see. Some more 1-mana cyclers. Some random nonsense. Cunning Nightbinder is sweet. 2-mana, a 2-2 flash. Spells with flash you cast cost 1 less and can't be countered. This guy puts a counter on your things. That card is decent for humans. And we have our first legendary and our first mythic as the first pack. Okay.
That's a great start, dude.
Yep. Chevel, Bane of Monsters. He's black, green, 1/3 death touch. At the beginning of your upkeep, if your opponent's controlled no permanents with bounty counters on them, put a bounty counter on target creature or planeswalker an opponent controls. Whenever a permanent opponent controls with a bounty counter on it dies, you gain 3 life and draw a card. So his whole thing is killing everything. That's his goal.
Now, to be fair, that's a totally reasonable card you could actually play.
That's very true. So that's a good start. Okay, so we've got some nice dual land over here. So,
you know what's funny, Mike? Good. I actually might be able to play my entire deck from my box because I opened 4 of each basic land. So I think I actually might have my entire deck from my box, even including basics.
So this card's cool. 3 mana, 2/2 Menace in Rakdos colors. Each creature you control with Menace can't be blocked except by 3 or more creatures. That'll be nice in this kind of format. Splendor Mare, when you can cycle it and give a creature a lifelink counter. Okay. Song of Creation. I don't know if that's going to be good.
I kind of doubt it, but
if you can make it work, it'll be awesome. The issue is that we're probably playing a format with really high mana costs.
Yeah.
So the deck that I am going for is going to say, be either Gigantha, or I'd really like one of the mythic. There's like the Saltai or the Teemer mutate. Like there's one that mutates and one that can mutate from graveyard. They're both just gonna be really really good for the colors, I guess. We'll see if I can get a mutate deck. Like this is an awesome mutate card right here. You can mutate and search for a basic land to put it on the battlefield tapped. So that one's gonna be really nice.
All ramp is good ramp for this.
Anticipate is gonna be good.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Here's another good mutate card, but it's in red. Here's one that's whenever it mutates, you create a 3/3 beast. It's gonna be nice. We have a crystal that can cycle, tap, you know, taps for mana. Shark Typhoon is gonna be fantastic. We are going to blitz.
You hit a shark typhoon?
Yes, so far, so good.
I was like, that's a super strong card in this. That's a snowballer for sure.
Oh yeah. Okay, so we're 4 packs deep. It's already looking pretty good.
No doubt, dude. No doubt.
Essence Scatter, great counterspell. Corpse Turn, mill top 3 and put a creature from grave to hand. Yeah. Pretty good.
I forget. Aquaria does have the 3-mana ramp artifacts, though, doesn't it?
It does. Those are going to be nice. There's a lot of fixing. And here we have a Fertilid, which, of course, I'm going to get one because it's a common, well, assuming. Which can ramp twice. It's a 3-mana 2/2. You can remove a counter from it and search for a basic land. Target player searches for a basic land.
That's awesome.
This one mutates for 4 mana to return an artifact or creature. No, just creature. An opponent controls to its owner's hand. Migration Path, which is search for 2 basics, put them into play tapped. Cycling 2.
It's better ramp. It's better exposure to meditation.
We got the Kogla.
Did you get the Kogla? You'll love to see the Titan Ape, dude. The thicky boy.
I love that card. I will find a way to play this card.
I mean, what command, like, you could honestly play mono green with him, but that's probably...
If I get lucky enough to get enough good green cards, I probably will.
Yeah, I think that's for sure reasonable.
Here's a good cycler. He's 2 mana, 2/2. When you cycle a card, you gain a life. He also has cycling 1. I think the cycling cards are going to be very relevant for this deck, regardless of what I play. Stormwild Crapador is cool. 3 mana, 1/3. If damage, non-combat damage would be dealt to it, you put a +1/+1 counter on it instead and prevent the damage. The rare, I didn't realize that was at the rare. Cub Warden. It's a 4-mana 3/5. It can mutate for 2/2 white. And when it mutates, create 2 cats with lifelink. I'm not really a big white player, but, you know, maybe it'll be good. We've got Farfinder. This card's great. 3 mana, 1/1 Vigilance. It searches for a basic land to put it into your hand. This card's awesome because it is a fox and you can mutate onto it. More cyclers. We got Ram Through. It's a incinerate type spell for your, you know, it's a green removal. It's way too good. Evolving Wilds, always great. We got another crystal. I think that's the same one that I opened, but regardless, it's a crystal. And there's a crystalline giant. This card's insane. Beginning of combat on your turn, you can choose a kind of counter at random that it doesn't have. The counters include flying, first strike, death touch, hexproof, lifelink, menace, reach, trample, vigilance, and +1/+1. And at the beginning of combat on my turn, he'll always get a counter at random. It's really hard to keep track of, but that's definitely more of an arena card, but it's going to be good. Yep. Okay. There's another Great Horn. Some random stuff here. When he mutates, he sacks a creature. That's nice. Dire Tactics. It's a white and a black exile target creature. If you don't control a human, you lose life equal to the toughness. Who cares? It's a removal spell.
Do you think you're going to be playing a mutate deck? Or do you think
I'm
you're...
hoping so, but if not, no big deal. I think there's a lot of different good themes in here, like humans and cycling and stuff. But mutate would definitely be what I'm... Oh, Charges of Forever Beast. I didn't even see that.
Nice.
Yeah, that's a good removal spell. But yeah, here's a reanimate spell. Return creature from grave to battlefield with lifelink for 5. Here we have our second legendary. That would
cool.
be General Kudrow of Draenith. 1/1 black, 3/3, other
humans
get +1/+1. When him or another human enters the battlefield under your control, exile target card from an opponent's graveyard, pay 2, sack 2 humans, destroy target creature with power 4 or greater. So that is decent. I don't want to play black-white, but...
If you have to play humans, he's probably the... Like, if you have to build black-white humans, like... There's worse things because he's a lower removal in the command zone. So, I mean.
Yep. Here's whenever you cycle a card, it's a 2-mana, 2/3/2. When you cycle a card, you can pay 2, and if you do, it deals 2 damage to a creature and you gain 2 life. Here's a nice removal spell for white. Ominous Seas. Awesome card. It goes infinite with greater good. And we have Extinction Event. Here we see our first Wrath. Choose odd or even, exile each creature with converted mana cost of the chosen value.
That's
awesome,
really good.
Awesome card. Yeah, that's going to be fantastic. We have a ton of packs left. I'm still hoping for some Mutate. Still hoping for some Gigantha, maybe like a Sweet Foil Zerda or something.
Hit the Foil Zerda.
Yeah.
Let's get there.
Oh, that's awesome. I love these. I don't know how good you can see them. The alternate art cards.
Oh yeah, so for
cool.
sure. When I open my Aquaria stuff, if you want, I can just like give you the after we're done with this series, all the alternate art ones.
Yes.
I don't particularly care for them. So
it's called Profit.
It's all,
awesome.
All you do.
This one's a 3/1 for black and green. Tap add black or green, or tap to put the top 2 cards of your library into your graveyard. Duskfane Mentor again, and Dirgebat. Ooh, my god. Ooh. Okay, so Dirgebat is a 4-mana 3/3 flash flying. You can mutate it for 4 black-black, and whenever this creature mutates, destroy target creature or planeswalker an opponent controls. Fantastic card. If we were able to get a blue-black flash deck, that would be awesome. And then we have the foil, the Ozolith. There's some spice. Whenever a creature you control leaves the battlefield, if it had counters, put those counters on the Ozolith. The beginning of combat, if the Ozolith has countered, you can move it from the Ozolith onto target creature. Amazing. So we got a foil rare.
It's awesome, dude.
Oh, Wynota would be nuts.
That's true.
Okay, we got some cyclers, essence scatters. Yep, let's get to the goods. Here's legendary creatures. Legendary humans you control have indestructible. White, black, 2/3. He works with General Kudrow. Again, hoping we're not on the humans plan, but you never know. Heartless Act adds a Doomblade. Beautiful. Whenever you cycle a card, you may have this enchantment become a 5/4 dinosaur with trample and haste. Pretty sweet. Lurrus of the Dream Den.
Hey.
So, black white's looking real spicy.
Lurrus. I was going to say, you're, dude, is it possible to build, unironically, a Lurrus companion? Like,
that would be so hard.
Is there a world you think you could pull that off, or is that just, like, super unrealistic?
It's possible, but I think you have to get very lucky.
Yeah, probably Lurrus 99, then.
Yeah, either in the 99 or
Commander.
So we got some, commons, get to the goods. Here's a Huntmaster Liger with alternate art. Lead the Stampede, amazing card. Each creature spell you cast costs 1 less if it has mutate, and whenever you cast a creature, if it has mutate, draw the discard. Slither Wisp, there's a blue-black flash card, is a 3/2 flash. When you cast another spell that has flash, you draw a card, and each opponent loses 1 life. Awesome. So I don't have a direction that I'm going yet.
I will say, you are very open right now.
We are all over the place currently. We finally got a pacifism and a dead weight, so that's nice. Drainus Stinger is nice for cycling. Skip past all that. Let's get to the goods. We are at the goods. Okay. We've got a Humble Naturalist. Tap to add 1 mana of any color and only to cast a creature, but it's ramp and it's a 2 mana 1/3.
That's ramp.
Parcel Beast is amazing. 4 mana 2/4. You can tap one and tap it. Look at the top card of your library. If it's a land, you may put it on the battlefield. And if you don't, put it into your hand. You can also mutate it for blue green. Here we have another human. We have a Neutralize, which is a good counter spell. And here we have a legendary, an awesome legendary.
Oh, is it?
Gruga, the Micro Sage. This is probably interesting. I think I might end up playing Simic, you never know. But he's good just in the 99 in general.
Yeah.
When he enters, you draw a card for each other permanent you control with CMC 3 or greater. He's a 5 mana 4/5.
Oh, that's where I know him from. Okay, he's the companion.
And we've got this cycling card for 3, exile up to 3 target enchantments. Yeah, that is unfortunate. You can't play Lurrus and Kudro together because Kudro is 3 mana. Same reason you can't play Timna Thrasios with Lurrus, which would have been amazing.
You're not wrong. The fact that you can't do Timna Lurrus is kind of tragic. Like, you can play with a super sweet farm deck like that.
Yeah. Dreamtail Huron with the alternate art is cool. Fire Prophecy is a kill spell. So that's a nice one. It's one of the best kill spells. I'll skip past this Brushwag, even though I know Sean would just love to see that. We have a Zenith Flare. Unfortunately, you only get to play one of these. But it deals damage to any target equal to the number of cyclers in your graveyard, and you gain that much life. More these things, more cycly boys. We got some spice, a Whirlwind of Thought. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, draw a card, enchantment, Jeskai colors. And we have a foil Honey Mammoth, sweet. See, I'm not very organized. I throw all my stuff in a pile and figure it out later.
I was going to say.
I'm just putting the really good stuff in its own pile. And I'll figure out the rest later.
Reasonable.
Okay. Skip past these commons. Greater Sandworm is going to be good.
For sure.
Okay. Whenever this creature mutates, exile cards from the top of your library until you exile X permanents, or X is the number of times this creature is mutated. Put those permanents on the battlefield. That card will be nasty, and you can mutate for 6. That lets you cast a card with cycling from your graveyard. Escape Protocol. Whenever you cycle, you can exile a creature. And we have a Triumph, our first Triumph, and it's alternate art.
Oh, nice, dude.
This one is the Indatha, which would be Abzan or black, green, white, or junk, if you will. Has many names.
Any of the above.
Okay. Let's get past all this stuff. Ooh. We have Flame Spill, deal 4 damage. It's the burn spell with trample. Primal Empathy, amazing Simic card. Well, I'm hoping for Simic here. Boon of the Wishgiver, cycling 1, 6 mana, draw 4 cards. Death's Oasis, we have another Abzan card. This card has a lot of text, but it's just a value engine for Abzan. That's what we're going to see. It has way too much text. Okay. Common goo over here. Necropanther. More good Orzhov cards. When it mutates, you can return a creature, CMC 3 or less, from grave to battlefield. Another barrier breach. Fight as one is sweet and feather. Unpredictable cyclone. If a cycling ability of another non-land card would cause you to draw instead of exile cards until you share it. Card that shares its type and then cast that card without paying its mana cost. It has cycling too. That's a wild cycling card. Lurking Deadeye as foil. When it ETBs, destroy target creature that was dealt damage this turn. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna open the box topper last. Pile of commons. We've got another one of these guys that puts a Menace counter or a different type of counter. Monstrous Step, it has cycling. Bastion of Remembrance is a good one. When it enters, create a 1/1 soldier. Whenever a creature you control dies, each opponent loses 1 life and you gain 1 life. Amazing card. And we have our first beautiful, feeling good. mythic
Getting there.
legendary creature of the Jeskai colors.
Yeah,
This
buddy.
one has mutate. It's 3 mana, blue, red, white, 3/3. Mutate, you may cast a spell for its mutate, all that stuff. Flying First Strike, when it mutates, you may cast target non-creature card with CMC3 or less from your graveyard without paying its mana cost. So I'm
Pretty
happy with
solid,
that. I'm
honestly.
happy with that. Now, if I open Gigantha,
Honestly,
I get to
what
play
you
all of
really
these.
want is Gigantha,
Yep.
but the other thing you'd want is a mutate with Orzhov in it, based off of what you've opened so far.
That's true. That's true. Okay, so Grim Dancer and ETBs with two different counters of your choice, Minus Death, Ultra Lifelink, solid playable. Another crystal, which is of the Saltai variant, Reconnaissance Mission, which is amazing. Whenever a creature you control does combat damage to a player, draw a card. And here we have Kahira, another legendary creature. This one's Selesnya. This one is each other creature, 3/3/2 Vigilance, Cat Beast. Each other creature that's a cat, elemental, nightmare, or dinosaur. Or beast gets +1/+1 and has vigilance that you control. Jeskai is good. I still prefer Saltite. I want to be playing these sweet green cards, these sweet blue cards. Okay, this is our first uncommon. It's a mediocre mutate card, but it looks cool. Enchanted creature gets -2/-0, so it loses all abilities. Whenever this
it's
creature
not bad.
mutates, yeah. Ooh, we have our first really big boy. Actually, we have our, this is our, what, second really big boy? Yep. This is a 5-mana 6/6 in Gruul. Whenever one or more creatures you control with Trample deal combat damage, create an XX Dinosaur Beast with Trample.
That is good.
And then we've got another of these mutate cards, but this one's foil. I did open, ooh, I didn't pull out my Karuga. That's true, that was my other legendary. You at Karuga. Okay. If we have options, we definitely have options. Okay. Get all these commons out here. More Fertilid. This card's awesome. Back for more. Reanimate a creature, and when you do, it fights up to one target creature you don't control. It does cost 6.
Still super good for that cost, though.
Yep. Easy Prey. Flourishing Fox is nutso. It's like the best cycling card. And we have a beautiful, beautiful Mythos of Iluna. This is a 4-mana sorcery clone. If you copy a target permanent, if you spent red green to cast it, then if it's a creature, it fights up to one target creature you do not control. Yeah, this does seem like an awesome Teemer Stompy deck. I'm just missing the Teemer Stompy commander.
Honestly, you're missing the commander for it.
That's gonna make it a little difficult. Okay, another Evolving Wilds, and we've got a... This mutates and taps creatures, very expensive. Channeled Force is awesome for discarding and then drawing another crystal. Sea Dasher Octopus, amazing card. 3-mana 2/2 Flash, when it deals combat damage to a player, draw a card. You can mutate for one in a blue. Foil Tranquil Cove. We have a ton of fixing. The Gigantic Dream is definitely still alive.
No doubt. I mean, it's alive until the last pack. And like I said,
yep.
the main thing is going to be fixing to be able to play
all the
colors.
Totally honest, I accidentally started at the beginning. But I got this sweet foil alternate art Parcel Beast.
Reasonable.
Hopefully I get to play that. And, oh, that's awesome. I got the alternate art Lord Drakus. When it mutates, return an instant source free from grave to hand. It's in Izzet colors. Awesome. This is another cycler. Call of the Death Dweller. It's a reanimate spell for CMC3 or less. And we have the biggest of the bigs, Colossification. When it enters, tap enchanted creature. Enchanted creature gets +20/+20 for 7 mana. The best
Honestly,
thing to do with
probably
that,
super good.
I'd play it. The best thing to do with that is to tap their blocker with it and kill them.
Yes.
Of course, of course.
Totally.
I've seen it happen.
Oh, I bet.
Okay. So we got a red card here. 5 mana. Target creature fights another target creature. Seems good. Removal. 4 mana, 3/3 First Striker. Another Cycler. And another Ozolith. Not great. Not a great pack. Yep, we're still praying for the five color. I don't know if I'd play Karuga or Vadrock. I think I would be leaning towards Karuga right now. But it's tough. We also have, I still have a lot of packs to open, so. Sprite Dragon. Good. Another Cycling Death Toucher. A counter thingy. And this thing. Oh my god. I just got... So this card is a 3-mana, 4-5 menace. When he enters the battlefield, target opponent puts a Death Touch counter...
Oh, it's the black one. Yeah, okay.
And we also have a Foil Vivian, Monster's Advocate. this lets you...
Actually getting there, then.
Insane. You may look at the top card of your library at any time, and you may cast creature spells from the top of your library. Plus one creates a 3/3 beast with a bunch of different abilities. Minus two, which is the important part. You may cast your next creature spell this turn, or when you cast your next creature spell, search your library for a creature card with lesser converted mana cost and put it on the battlefield.
Yeah, getting there.
Beautiful green cards. I'm okay with this. Okay. This is a Trample Boy. It's another Mutate card. We got another Crystal, so that's good. And we got Titan's Nest. Oh, the Salt Eye Dream. Now, this card, I got to call this one out, because this card is amazing in Commander. It's a blue, black, green enchantment. Beginning of your upkeep, look at the top card. You may put that card into your graveyard. Exile a card from your graveyard. You can add a colorless. And spend only to cast a colored spell without X and its mana cost. But it's a really good ramp, and it's really good like late game. Just fixing, you know, your draws and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Got another general, or General's Enforcer, another Ominouses, and another Cycler.
I mean, that Vivian is going to be the best card you open, I would argue. The Vivian's so good.
It probably is.
Isn't it a foil? Isn't that a foil mythic or a foil rare?
It is a foil mythic.
Yeah, buddy, dude, getting it.
Okay, so we have 8 packs left. 10 packs left.
10 packs? All right, not bad. I have faith. The five color dream. Let's not have to make a hard choice.
Yeah. Some cyclers, something. Mythos of Brokos. And
what color is that?
It's green and blue black. So Saltai Dream still holding on. And we got a foil raptor thingy. Personally, I liked Ikoria. I did not like the companions, but only because they were incredibly broken when they first came out, and they were taking over every format.
They took over every format that's not Commander, and they were cool for Commander, and then once the rules change happened, they died out of every format and became, like, just... It's so not worth it now. Yeah. It's so... I wanted to play Giganta in, like, a five-color Jeskai Ascendancy deck, but, like, it's just... It hurts. It's really bad now.
So this card's awesome. It's a 5-mana 5/4 with flash. When it enters the battlefield, counter target artifact or creature.
That is good.
Okay. Let's just move this stuff. Now, here is a 3-mana 2/2 flying with 3 random text. A second neutralize. A second reptilian reflection. And a Saltai Mythic. This one says, I don't know, it's a 5-mana 6/6. That's the relevant part. The not so relevant part says, actually, you know, it is kind of relevant for mutate. You can mutate this creature. It's a 6/6 trample for 5, and you may cast it from your graveyard using its mutate ability. That is going to be an awesome commander.
It's that the legendary one, isn't it?
It is legendary. Yeah. It's perfect. That is exactly what I needed.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, we are very happy with that. That's... second best possible commander that I think I could get here. Giganta, still holding on hope. But Brokos is fantastic. I have so many good Saltai cards I get to play.
Okay. For sure.
So we've got a bunch of things I've already opened. And this one's got a Bonder's Enclave. It's a land. You can tap it for colorless. You can tap 3 and tap it to draw a card. Activate only if you control a creature power 4 or greater. Yeah, this is going to be a beautiful, beautiful Sultai deck.
I was going to say, you're definitely locked into that Sultai almost.
Okay. So more cards we've already opened. It's very surprising how many similar uncommons have gotten. Valiant Rescuer is nice. When you cycle another card, you can get 1/1. The rare is a second Cub Warden, but this one looks cool. And a Boot Nipper, which I already have, but it's foil. Okay. Moving on. Looks like we've got Boneyard Lurker. That's awesome. When this creature mutates, you can return target permanent card from a graveyard to your hand. And its mutate is 4, its cast cost is 4, it's a 4/4. This one, when it mutates, each opponent loses X life and you gain X life, where X is the number of times this creature is mutated. Our rare is red. And this is Yidaro, Wandering Monster. It's a 7-mana 8/8 with Trample and Haste. You can cycle it, and if you cycle it, you shuffle it into your library from your graveyard. The rest of the text doesn't matter for Commander, but it's decent. Also, it is legendary. If I decide to go mono-red, keep that in mind. Something tells me that I won't be doing that.
Really? Why is that?
Okay. Now we're looking real good. I just opened a Garuda Doom of Depths. And that is...
That's a big Sultai boy.
Yep.
That can be played in that Sultai deck.
Each player mills 4, and then I can return any creature with an even CMC from among those cards onto the battlefield. I could even play this as a partner if I really wanted to. It would just take some work.
You think so?
I also got a crystal. And another Skull Prophet. Weaponize the monsters is cool. I could. It would just be very hard. I couldn't play Vivian, though. Yeah, it looks like I'm stacking everything on one creature, probably. Okay. Foil Neutralize.
Good start.
And I got the card that Folger needs, which is Inspired Ultimatum. This one's...
unfortunate.
Yeah, that's pretty unfortunate.
Literally the best one for me.
Yep, we're definitely on Sultai. I've got 2 packs left. I get to play Kogla, I get to play Shovel. This is going to be an awesome deck. Lutri.
Ban!
Bye! And there's another Parcel Beast. The third one, and all 3 of them are different. This is a non-foil version of it. So I have a regular, a foil, and a non-foil. I should have ripped... I was actually really tempted to rip that Lutri in half. But I won't. Just for the memes, you know. Last pack. So, Giganta could still get us there. In this pack.
Gigantha does get you there.
That's the hope.
If not, you've got Sultai with Garuda. So that's something.
I have a foil rare, Lava Brink Venturer. I'm not going to be playing it, but it's pretty decent. And we have a red Planeswalker.
Did you hit Chevelle?
I hit Luca.
Oh no, yeah, that's the good one, isn't it? That's awesome. You hit both. You can only play Vivian, though.
I know. I might still open another commander. So I did get a Luka, which is cool. I'm happy that I opened it. It is unfortunate that I don't get to play it. For now. You never know when I open up my other packs.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I'm going to open my box topper. I mean, overall, I would say value-wise, pretty good. Not incredible, but Foil Vivian is definitely awesome. And I got a lot of really cool stuff for this format, so that'll be fun. I got the Kogla that I wanted.
Yeah.
Okay. This pack is really hard to open. I'm bending the card up. Hopefully it's not... What even is this? Caesar, Ancient Guardian.
That's a bad one. Sorry, bud.
Yeah, when it mutates, it's an uncommon. It looks cool, but yeah, it's not a playable cool card. Box Hopper to get, that would have been funny.
That would have been hot.
Okay, so this Lutri is going to chill over here. Out of sight. Yeah. Out of sight, out of mind. Okay, so now I think, do you want me to deck build? Do you want to deck build?
I've sorted all my cards while you were opening your box, so I say we do mine. Perfect. And that'll give you time to divvy yours up as well.
Let's do it. There's no Giganta,
so
it's still pretty good.
Yeah, let me swap back over and get my camera right as rain.
Yep. Okay, let me just fling all my cards everywhere.
All right.
Okay, we're
You can
hopping over
swap
to
back over to
Boulders.
me.
Yep, there we go.
So what I've just done is color sorted all my stuff, took out stuff that I would say is almost 100% playable out of the non-rares. And if I don't know if you can tell, there are zero white cards here. I don't know what that says, but yeah. Look through that white section. I don't know if there's really anything I'd like to play. As far as multicolor goes, also not too much. Besides, obviously, Risen Reef and obviously Tonebound Witch. Those two cards are super good for this deck. So yeah, I guess let's get brewing, Mike. My main question is, as color intensive as this deck is going to be, I think I run one Cryptic Caves just to search it with Golos.
I would definitely play Cryptic Caves.
Yeah, there's like never. It's my one colorless source.
One colorless is not going to hurt
you.
It
draws a card if I flood.
Yep.
So, I guess let's do mana first. Cryptic Caves. We've got the Evolving Wilds. I think we're probably playing all nine that I opened. Maybe not. I'm playing all five temples. I'm not really very white heavy at all. Like, what white am I actually playing? Kaikar?
You have that
Johnny.
If you're playing the Angel, but the Angel is seven mana.
I'm probably playing the Angel. Sephara, Loxodon, Life Chanter. I'm super white on white. So this is basically a splash white four color. So let's see. These are for sure played. White, white, and white. Okay, so these are for sure getting played. Those 10 plus these two, which is 12. I think I probably play these as well, just because more fixing is better. Now, having how many tap lands is that? 10, 15 tap lands is not great. I think the fixing...
It's going to be
slow. It's going to be slow, but like I don't think this deck wins the early game ever and just dominates the end game, is realistically like.
Yeah, I could see that. Oh, I don't get to play Luris. It's so sad.
I'm so sorry. All right. So for my mana base, I've got 15 duels and an Evolving Wilds. I've got the Cryptic Caves. And then, so that's 16. And then if I were to just play four of each basic, or maybe I skew it a little bit and play three planes and the most of whatever else. I think I keep it like that. I guess I need the white for Golos activations as well. So I think four of each is probably the safe way to do it with all my fixing. And I just need to get to five mana and then can just cast Golos and grab what I can. That immediately fixes my mana with Golos.
Yeah.
So, I mean, all right. I'm going to send this out to the chat and get your guys' opinion as well. What do you think my land count needs to be? Because I think 36 might be a little bit greedy. Where are we feeling at 36?
I'd be happy with 36, I think. And you definitely want to hit your land drops. You don't want to be missing land drops.
Yeah,
your whole goal here is just play Golos, and then next turn you have 7 mana and activate Golos.
Exactly.
I think that's like your whole game plan, so...
Pretty much.
I don't even know if I'm playing Colossification, but it just seems risky.
It's a little risky, yeah, but it's hot.
So we got Mutate.
I don't think I need Prismite for fixing. I think that's overkill. So it's a 2-mana colorless 2/1 that has activated ability, pay 2 colorless, add 1 of any color. I don't think I need it with my mana base.
No, I don't think so. I
I
wouldn't
did
play
open
it.
my scuttle month though. That's all that matters. So I think 36 lands is probably fine.
You've got a lot of the chat saying more like 37, 38, a lot of
They're saying
38s.
more? A lot of
Yeah.
38s,
Yep. Some people are saying 34, but yeah, I'm not sure about that.
That's no. I it's at a minimum 36. If I'm at, what's the math on it? 36, a little over a third. I should be able to get to like five, or if I can hit, I need to hit what, five land drops? Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, I really need six because I want to ramp into my, I want a five Golos, grab a land, play the land, activate
Yeah,
Golos.
true.
So I need to be able to hit six. So I might push that to 38 or 39, actually. I think 39 is what I'm leaning towards. And then add a basic of the Sultai variety because that's what I'm playing the most of. One of each. I think that's reasonable. So I think I'm going to be playing 39 lands, all five scries, nine of the gain one life duels.
Yeah.
Which, hold on, what's my gain one life duel I'm missing? Is it blue red? Yeah, I'm missing the blue red gain one life land, which is fine. I've got the Evolving Wilds. I've got my one-off Cryptic Caves. Actually, as far as mana goes, do I play? Where is it? Lotus Fields.
Can build a pretty aggro Jeskai deck. Now that I'm looking at it.
That's pretty hot.
Yeah.
Lotus Field can't be good, right? Like, what am I doing with Lotus Field, honestly? Like nothing.
Yeah, I don't know.
Don't think I'm doing anything worthwhile, that's for sure.
Okay, so this is good, but I think I already had this in the pile.
There's a sleeve. Carbon dead out of here. Golos. I guess yeah, I'll just keep it like this. There's the Golos. Okay. So obviously non-negotiably Golos is the commander. I'm for sure playing Yarok and Kaikar. For sure playing all three of the Mythic Walkers. Chandra's a maybe. I'm playing all Pyro. Definitely play all five of my big boys. I guess those are white heavy.
I did get somebody asked me what lands I got. I got an Evolving Wilds. I'm sure I have the gain life lands here somewhere. But yeah, not much else.
Elvish Reclaimer's fixing. Agent of Treachery is for sure in there. You know, my Agent of Treachery came out the pack with a nick. Coming for you, Watsy.
Oh.
I don't know if, yeah, there it is. Can you see the little top there?
Oh wow. Yeah, that's actually pretty big.
Yeah. Think I have.
I've got a dual
Have
backwater.
a non-foil agent treachery in the binder somewhere? Nah, it's in the box somewhere. I'll look for that later. Not worth it right now, but I'm for sure playing Agent of Treachery. Mystic Forge. Probably not. Flood of Tears for sure. Dungeon Geists for sure. Ambusher for sure. I don't know about Dread Presence or Icon.
Dread Presence probably isn't that good. I mean, because you're not running enough swamps for it to really be relevant.
Yeah. I don't think I'm running five swamps, so I don't think Dread Presence is good enough then. Icon of Ancestry is really good with Kaikar. Not very good with anything else. I think I play Leyline just because it's good. Anything else that's just like this thing? Veil of Summer, Tail's End. I don't know where they. I think I'd probably play Tail's End just to counter Commanders.
Yeah, I'd play it for sure.
Yeah. And I don't know about Veil of Summer, though. Unironically, I don't know how relevant that's going to be.
At worst, it's one mana draw card.
That's probably fair. I think it's probably good enough off of that.
I definitely did not get enough basics.
I have a bunch of cards that just like kind of win me the game if they stick.
You have a lot of those.
Yeah, like Villis, any of my walkers, Dracoseth. Okay. Here's Golos. Let's just start counting up my like auto include playables and go from there. Here's the stack. We got one. I've got 49 and then 50 with Golos. With my. So that means I need at least 11 more cards. This is where the actual Bruin is going to come in, where I don't. I got to come up with 11 cards that are. Wait, do I not have Yarchmoke Crasher in here yet? Maybe 10 cards. 10 cards. Golos, blue, black, light, red, multicolored, green, and colorless.
I'm assuming when you mutate a creature onto one of your creatures, I'm assuming that doesn't count as commander damage.
I have no idea.
anybody in the chat now?
Here's a question, Mike.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on like the reanimation thing? Is that decent? Or I actually don't know. I only have exactly one, which is Blood for Bones. 3 and a black for as an additional cost, sack a creature, return a creature from your graveyard to the battlefield, then return another creature card from your graveyard to your hand.
Yeah, I don't think you need to go deep on it. I don't think you have enough.
Well, I don't. Neither do I. I'm just saying. Do you think that's reasonable?
I mean, if you're looking for playables, I would say yeah.
I am in fact looking for playables. Multicolored. Green. Okay. Thoughts on Season of Growth. I actually think this card is going to be super strong. It's whenever a creature enters the battlefield under your control, scry one. And then whenever you cast a spell that targets a creature you control, draw a card. The second part, I don't know if I'll ever get to trigger, but just scry one on all my creatures that double triggers with the Auroch for 2 mana seems decent.
Yeah, I'd play it.
Yeah.
I guess I'll organize by CMC.
Okay. With the Scampering Scorcher, 3 and a red for a 1/1 elemental that when it enters the battlefield, you make 2 other 1/1 red elemental creature tokens, and elementals gain haste until end of turn. So it's a 4 mana for 3 1/1s. isn't terrible,
It's good with
but
Chandra. Other than that, I don't know.
it's really well, Risen Reef is why I would play it.
Okay. I mean, yeah, if you think that you need that effect, I would
How
play it,
only
but
does what other do I have any other elemental synergy?
so people in chat are saying it is okay. So you're so like say that I have a 2/2 attacking flyer and I mutate it. That counts as commander damage, or does. That's what I mean. If I mutate him, my commander onto something and then attack, or, that counts as commander damage. Okay, I'm gonna go by CMC here. Actually, I think mine turned out pretty decent.
I'd agree. So I think I just it's the playable the last 10 are what's gonna give me some issues. I think I just play removal. Actually, that's a good question. How much removal do I really have? Villas kind of, but really murder, noxious grasp. I think I opened a pacifism. That's a thing. Master Splicer, reasonable.
Okay, that's awesome actually.
Is?
Just the fact that I can mutate onto other creatures and hit for commander damage, I think that's gonna be my win con.
You think?
I mean, 'cause I can just keep recasting him and mutating him from the graveyard over and over.
That is good. I honestly don't even. I don't think disenchant is worth playing. There's no. This is like all gonna be just creature beats and spells.
Yeah.
Like I don't see any artifacts or enchantments that are popping off. Just pacifism.
Good thing about playing in Ikoria is that all of my like if I need a bunch of spots just to fill, I can just play cyclers.
Yeah, that is nice. Honestly, these are the 10 cards that are going to get swapped out as soon as we hit week two, for sure.
Oh yeah.
Which is super nice. Like, I got good enough off my original box that it should be fine. So, here we are. I'm okay playing these. So, that's six. Ten. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49. 50, 51, 52, and 53 with Golos, which means I need to add, I think it's eight cards or nine cards. Use seven more. I guess my uncommon Chandra is probably going to get played.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, we're not opening a different box each week. What's gonna happen is tomorrow Zach and Ryan, the other two players that are gonna be in our pod, are gonna be opening their boxes at same time, 7 p.m. And we're going to be recording gameplay videos. We're not gonna be streaming our sorry, let me back up. So we're going to be opening six extra packs of a different set each week. And adding cards to our deck or changing commanders from those six packs. And that goes on for a month. We're going to be recording the gameplay, and that's going to be that's basically the next step. We don't open extra boxes or anything like that. But I do have 18 packs just here that I really want to open that I'm not opening.
Heard. I mean, a 6-mana 7/7 elemental was probably worth playing.
I have a giant maybe pile. Commander's Legends will be something entirely different, although
Oh,
this
yeah.
format was designed with Commander Legends in mind. Commander Legends is going to be like just beautiful for this format. I mean, it's going to be so awesome. You're going to, you're going to
I
have so many
mean,
commanders. That's a whole different
to
world.
I was like, if you were going to play this format, and then you just picked, everyone would always pick Commander Legends first. But technically, for this format, it's not legal because it's not a standard legal set. But I will put it this way, that you, if you have Commander's Legends, you should just do it ha like you should play it the way it's supposed to, with like the 5 booster packs and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I'm really looking forward to that. That's definitely something we're probably going to do as well.
We definitely are. That's gonna be super fun.
I guess negate is a playable. Not a great one, though. It's not a great one at all.
Sweet. This deck is so cool. I have a, like, I don't even know, it's like 1,000 cards right now though, but this pile is awesome.
Maybe fried. Let's see. White or blue? I don't like the super conditional really like that. I can help it. Is a 2-mana 2/2 that taps for 1 red? Does that cast enough? One, two, three. Four, five, six, seven.
Oh yeah, yep. My altar website is sadrobotaltars.com. I'm gonna go ahead and post it in the chat if anyone is looking to have their cards altered. My autocorrect is making it really hard to type, but we're getting there.
Yeah, as much as Chandra's Embercat is cool, I don't think it's playable. It taps for a red for 11 cards in my deck. I don't think that's quite good enough. Honestly, shock might be.
Shock? Yeah, I mean, it's probably playable, honestly.
Yeah, I think shock's actually reasonable. Act of Treason is another one that's a hard maybe.
Act of treason. If you had that way to sacrifice creatures, I would play it.
Yeah, I don't
Otherwise, it's
really.
just kind of eh.
Thing there.
Dreamtail Heron. Okay. I don't think Opposition Agent is going to be $50. It is.
I think it'll be 20 or 15.
Yeah.
I don't think it'll be 50. I think it'll be 15 to 20-ish.
It's a really, really. I cannot understate how good this card is. This card is.
Yeah,
insane.
It is.
But it's also.
It's Aven Mind Sensor that then craters grass.
Yeah. It's also a rare in a set that is going to be, like, insanely open.
I was gonna say, like, I think this may be one of the most open sets, like, ever.
Yeah.
Just, like, I don't see a world where it's over $20 ever.
Yeah.
Maybe a 6-mana 5/5 Death Toucher is just good enough.
Maybe. I have a stack of, like, I have, it's an embarrassment of riches. I have way too many cards.
That is embarrassing. It's messed up, dude. Yeah. Alright, let's count these bad boys up.
Yeah, I think Vampiric Tutor is going to drop in price.
I think Vamp drops sub 50. At least.
It's, and the thing about these sets is it's going to be like low for like a couple months, and then it's going to start crawling back up. That's just how it usually goes, especially for cards like that that are just good everywhere. So yeah, if I was going to pick up the cards, I usually wait like. Probably about a month after release. That's usually the sweet point for new sets. But yeah, hopefully, I really do hope they print to demand and it's not hard to get like the last couple sets. I still have, to this day, have not opened a pack of Jumpstart.
I was just saying, neither have
I. I don't even think I've seen a pack of Jumpstart in person. Are you, so are you still trying to add cards or cut cards?
I'm counting up my total right now. So that's what, 58 cards? So I guess I still need to add at least 3 or 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wait. This is 11. So I need 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 9. So I need 1 to 2 more cards. I mean, a 3-mana 4/4 flyer has got to be playable.
Oh, that is playable, yeah. Definitely is.
How about that? Like, sure. So, and then I just need, I believe.
You're not playing Gravedigger?
That was one of the cards where I'm, like, on the fence. We're, like.
I think it's playable. You're going to have creatures in graveyard. I mean, you think your creatures aren't going to die? It does double with Yorok.
Oh, I know.
I'm playing Disenchant. I'm blowing up the Golos. Get
dude, it. That's messed up. That's messed up, dude. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I think I got my death then. I think we got there. 39 lands. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 16. 36. I add one of each of the sulci. I guess what's my mana distribution? For sure, two, an extra brew source. For sure there. I have a lot of red. Like a lot of red. For sure a green, for sure a blue. It's either black or red. Or do I go to an even 40 and just not run Gravedigger?
Yeah, I mean, it's not a bad idea. As long as you're hitting your land drops, your goal is
doing
crazy stuff, you know?
Yeah, that's kind of my thing.
You don't even need cards. You just, like, keep activating Golos and you get there.
If I activate Golos every turn? Yeah. Yeah, exactly. That's kind of I think I'd drop the Gravedigger for that. I have my one Blood for Bones, which is, like, the first. I already have my pile of first things I'm cutting. Like, but. So this should be 60, and then I add a non-white basic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think Noxious Grass is probably good enough removal. Green, just the green.
I am never not playing Noxious Grasp. I would play all of those effects, honestly.
Would you? The because I have a white one that's black or red, I think it is. I don't know if I play that.
Maybe not that one, but like Aether Gust and the other one, definitely.
So you think green-red bounce?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it put on top?
Put on top is better than bounce. It's put Aether on top, Gust. I promise. I have played Counter target so spell. Much.
Its owner puts it on top for rare green.
The card is the bane of my existence for 2 years.
I think Aether Gust is reasonable. It's probably better than Shock, but I think Shock's probably good.
They're both good. Actually, I don't know.
I would probably cut Blood for Bone.
So what we're doing here is we open boxes for this league. It's going to be me versus Folger versus Zach versus Ryan. We each open a booster box and take one of the legendaries that we opened and basically build a deck out of it. Same rules as Commander, 100 cards, Singleton. Each week you add another 6 packs of a different set. So currently what we are doing is Folger opened Golos out of M20. And he is building a very spicy Golos deck out of his box.
Yep. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think I've got it now. Just counting. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
What partners do you think will show up in? And competitive so far.
Unironically, I think the Pirates are for sure there.
I'm on the same page too.
Those Pirates will see play.
The new Blue and Red Pirates? Oh god, they're awesome.
It's so hot, dude. Dockside's a pirate, dude. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. As far as other partners, let me just take a little look-see here. See what's spoiled so far.
Okay, I'm gonna hop over to
just
my screen so people can see.
Yeah, hop over your screen. So if we're looking for partners, this is for CEDH.
For CEDH. So this is my maybe pile right here. All of these cards are in the maybe pile. This is my cards I definitely want to play. These are my cyclers that don't actually do anything but have the word cycling on them. It's a lot of cards. So far, the raw power, if anybody that missed it, we opened the Mythic Mutate Legendary, Sultai colored, green, blue, black, and so I've gone pretty deep on the Sultai, just mutating. I've got all of the mutate, you know, I've got some Ominous Seas because that card's cool, lots of creatures that can get mutated, that's what my low curve is, just creatures to be mutated, interaction, we've got some You know, removal. When we have tons of mutate cards, all the good ones, the Great Horn, Sea Dash, or Octopus. This is kind of, I mean, it's a mid-range deck, but also it definitely wants to be attacking. This is definitely a beatdown deck. We've got, you know, so Titan's Nest is one of the cool cards I opened. We've got Boneyard Lurker. My big issue here is going to be cuts. And my top end, look at this top end. We got that Foil Vivian. We have the Voracious Gray Shark to counter. We've got Karuga to draw cards. Over here, we've got Dirge Bat that mutates to kill a creature or a planeswalker. Kogla, Shark Typhoon, and Garuda. So some really, really powerful stuff. The issue is going to be cutting and finding the right number of cantrip slash interaction slash how many mutate creatures do I play versus how many creatures do I play that want to be mutated on. And that's going to be the hard part. We've got probably, I don't even know how many cards this is. I'm going to add it up. It's going to hurt. It's so many. Okay, and I'm assuming we're probably going to just run 36 lands, I would say.
You think that's your number?
Yeah, I've got a couple cantrips. I actually have two. I have three ramp spells, I guess. Four or five? Five ramp spells? I could go higher, but we'll see. I also have cyclers. So maybe 36. Let's find out. Right here is 71 cards, including the commander.
I'm jealous.
Yeah, these are all cards 70, that I definitely want to play.
70 playables, dude. That's
yeah,
insane.
70 playables leaves me 30 lands. Leaves me 29 lands. Means I need to cut 7 cards.
To be a 36, yeah. Which I don't think will be too particularly hard. I think the worst 7 will probably stand out.
That's a maybe, but this creature seems kind of sweet. This one enters the 2/1. I want to make sure I have enough creatures early on that can be mutated, so I got to be careful with that.
Super important for your deck.
Yeah. Anticipate is possibly cuttable because it doesn't actually do anything.
That is kind of true, but it does just kind of get you there. Also.
I've got this Slither Wisp. Whenever you cast another spell that has flash, you draw, and each opponent loses one life. Does that? Oh, it has to have flash. I'm guessing so. It's not just instance, but literally flash.
Four other basics. Skadoosh.
Does anybody? I'm assuming that's what that means. Does anybody actually know that? I don't have any. Oh my god, you are right. Oh, that's awesome.
Here what
in
is
my,
it?
In my maybe pile, I've got this 6-mana 3/6 thing or whatever. Here it is.
Sure.
6-mana 3/6. It can either enter with flying or hexproof. Give that thing hexproof, slap this trample-y mutate on it. Now we're talking. That card's going in. That's a great suggestion. I just added a card, so now we have to cut 8 cards. Here's 3. 5 more. What do you all think about this one? It's a 2-mana 1/2. You can pay 1 to tap it and draw a card in the discard. So it's a looter, but it does cost a mana to activate. I'm going a little deep on the graveyard stuff. Because I have some ways to fill a graveyard and get cards back. Some of these are like obvious concludes. We've got Barrier Breach that I'm considering cutting. 3-mana exile up to 3 target enchantments, or you can cycle it for 2. That's on the cutting block. Bastion of Remembrance. We're not really a good wide deck, but it's decent. So that's a maybe. I have this 3-mana 4/5 Menace. When it enters the battlefield, target opponent puts a death touch counter on a creature they control. I think that seems fine. This is 3-mana cycle. When you cycle it, put the death touch counter on a creature you control. That's possibly cuttable. Protolid is amazing. We have this mole that enters in mills 3. Reconnaissance mission, whenever creature controls combat damage, draw a card, but it also has cycling. This mutates to put 2 plus 1 counters on it. That's possibly cuttable. Four mana, destroy target creature. Put a minus counter on a creature you control. Yeah, I don't know about that one. I mean, it's a kill spell for 4, but gives my creature menace and some maybe cut. Dark Bargain is cuttable.
For sure.
Yeah. I have a reanimate spell that gives the creature lifelink. That's kind of cool. Whenever this creature mutates, each opponent sacks a creature. When this creature mutates,
pretty decent if you're three. Since you're building mutate, that's gotta be worth.
Yeah. Yeah, these are all staying. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is exactly 8 cards that were maybe cuts. So I say I just cut these 8. I think we have a deck. Barrier Breach is pretty bad. Yeah, I was thinking that too. Dark Bargain. So these, yeah, if anybody has opinions on these, we got Blood Curdle. Destroy a creature for 4, put a minus counter. We've got Dark Bargain. Look at the top 3. 2 into hand, 1 into grave. Deals 2 damage. It's an instant. Barrier Breach, definitely cut. Void Beckoner is 8 mana, 8/8 Death Touch. You can cycle it for 3 and put a Death Touch counter on a creature you control. That one was amazing.
I kind of like that, actually.
I know, I do too. The issue is this, I don't really know what else to cut. Bastion of Remembrance, I would love to hear an opinion on that one. When it enters, create a 1/1 human. Whenever a creature you control dies, each opponent loses one and you gain one. But it's only
I think that's bad. Not a fan.
Okay.
I don't think a 1/1 is impactful enough.
Yeah, I guess just gaining life and yeah, that's not that good. So if we leave these 8 cards out, then we have a decent deck here. So I think I would be happy to play this deck. Some of the Yeah, Slither Wisp is out for sure. I think I just liked it because it was rare and it caught my eye, you know? So, some of the notable cards here. This creature mutates, target creature and opponent control because trolls gets -2/-2, Ivy Elemental. Got Shevel, Bane of Monsters. He's decent.
Honestly, I would play him for 2 minutes.
Yeah, I'm gonna play him. He just doesn't work with the mutate theme, I guess, but it's...
Oh, because it's non-human.
Yeah, but it's still good.
It's good enough. But...
Yeah. And I am playing Lead to Stampede, and we're on... Let's see how many creatures. Hopefully enough. It should be enough for Lead to Stampede. Humans, yep. I mean, this is everything Sultai wants to do. Let the card draw, removal, interaction. You know, your commander gives you late game value because you can just keep recasting him.
Got it.
This is definitely enough creatures. We've got Garuda, Kogla, look at that Kogla. Shark Typhoon.
Yeah. Shark Typhoon is I think unironically your best card.
Yeah. I have 3 reanimate spells in here.
That's hot.
Yeah. This is a pretty sweet deck. I'm happy with this.
I'm honestly super happy with mine. I came this close to hitting everything I wanted. Missed it by life. I missed the Field of the Dead by like. Oh. Had it.
That's not gonna work.
Throw in the box.
And here are my non-basics. I got all 3 of the Gain Life lands. I have the Evolving Wilds, and then I have Bonder's Enclave, and Everything else is a basic. Oh, I know. I know. I only have two humans in my deck. Three humans, so it shouldn't be too bad. Oh, four? I have four humans. That's fine. There's like 20 non-humans. Tons of ways to bounce. Plus, like, come on. The dream is to cast Kogla and go get, like, Karuga.
Yeah, I'm not kidding. With Vivian? Yeah, no kidding. Honestly, Vivian is, like, the best card in your deck by a laughably wide margin.
Yeah. A little rough for the lands. Yeah, here's the basics I opened, so. Well, do you think we have anything else?
I think that we've got our decks. So we've got... Who's your commander? It's the Sultai, but, like, what's its name, actually?
Brokos, Apex of Forever.
Yeah, Brokos, Apex of Forever, which is a kind of, like, Sultai mutate deck.
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's definitely deep on the mutate.
And then we've got Golos Big Boys, pretty much. Like, just...
So cool.
Yeah, those are the decks we have brewed from our box openings. I'm really looking forward to seeing how they do and to being able to add the last bit of cards from the extra sets we have.
Yes.
That's going to be a feels good one. We will not be doing those pack openings on stream or anything, but you will see... Oh, that is a spicy card, Mike. You will see all of the games that get played with these and the updates each week as we go on our channel. They will be turned into a gameplay series that we're doing. So hopefully you guys will stick around and look forward to that. Don't forget, tomorrow, Zach and Ryan are doing exactly what we did here today, which is opening their boxes, which is Dominaria and Zendikar Rising. And they will be doing the same thing Mike and I myself did, which was open it all, and then get their commander deck. So, yeah, I don't think I have anything else. Mike, do you?
I do not. This is going to be really, really fun. So if anybody is interested in doing their own box league, you know, grab a couple friends, play over webcam or whatever, and click that affiliate link down there, TCG Player. So thank you all for joining us tonight. Definitely more fun tomorrow. Have a good night, everybody.
Right. Thanks for coming out.